introducing queens to queenless hives can be a bit daunting. I watched a few videos from American guys. There's probably guys in England that do it as well. If you've laid out for a queen, a mated queen, 30 quid, I suppose, a lot of people are worried about losing it, people are worried about how to introduce it to the hive. I myself will be taking mated queens from small nukes and introducing them to a bigger queenless hive. And I've come across a few guys actually, that make a big queen cage, and we square the corners up on this. So 1/8 or 8mm hardware cloth, so you've got 8 squares to an inch, so the bees can't get through it. But we basically make a box that we then push into the frame. You make sure the frame's got some soon to be emerging brood in it, some food, bee bread, etc., and you've got your queen underneath it. And the queen, you can then put that frame into your hive, your queenless hive, leave it there for a week. The queen can walk all around underneath. She's got space to lay. Emerging brood then become her entourage, if you like, because they don't know any different. She's their queen, and it gives the rest of the bees a chance to accept the queen. And of course, she'll also be laying brood. Now, the only trouble I saw with it is getting the queen inside this, because a lot of people pick the queen up, and those people that watch my videos will notice I've got a shaky left hand, little disability. I don't let it bother me, but of course I don't like picking queens up with my hand. I try and use a one-handed queen catcher whenever I can. So it was some way, I had to figure out some way of putting that onto the frame just with the queen inside it, without damaging the queen. So you count 8 squares, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we cut 8 sections, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do the same this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, same on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See how bad my hand is when I'm trying to do intricate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now all we have to do is bend it. So you bend it where you've made the cuts. Try and get a nice sharp edge on it. Yep, like so. The two ends first. Sides. This is an inch. Those bits that you've cut, you can bend those in. Try and get it right the way down to the 1 inch. It's quite easy wire to bend. Got that so far. Now we just need to bend these two sides. Might be a case of just pinching it. following that line all the way down. Oh, that's easier, pull it upside down, as it were. Okay, that's the first bit done. There's our little box, our queen cage if you like. Now, that's what I've watched on YouTube. And of course, because of my shaky hand, I've come up with another idea of how to add, to make it a lot safer to put your queen in, if like me, you don't like picking them up. So, you'll have to excuse the mess. This is my man cave stroke beekeeping area. So you've got these four corners. I've noticed a lot of people don't even bother securing them, because by the time you push that into your sheet of a comb, that's going to make it rigid enough. But me being me, I do like to go the extra mile, just make them a bit more robust. So, although you could solder them, if you're any good at soldering, that's not my good point. Again, because of the handshake, one of the smallest cable ties that you can get. I think they're for doing electrical work or electronics work, and you can literally just pass it through the mesh. Okay, so due to me not setting up the camera properly, I'll do a really good speech on these things and you can't see what I'm looking at. But anyhow, we've got our queen cage if you like. I've put a little zip tie in each corner that just secures it. Then what I've done is I've cut a little flap out, so you can open that flap up. You can catch your queen in a one-handed queen catcher, or that's what I use, obvious reasons. You can find a nice frame that's got good brood on it, that's nearly emerging, some empty cells, a little bit of food, shake all your bees off, push that into the wax. You could put elastic band around it, I suppose, if you wanted to be extra careful or extra safe, but you could push it in at least half an inch. You then take your queen in the queen cage, put her on top, pull the slide to give her access. Queens tend to like to climb upwards, so you could even, whilst holding the queen cage on there, turn the whole lot upside down to make her climb up and into the cage. Once she's in there, and you know, wait for the opportune moment when she comes over to this side of the cage to simply shut that door. Push it a couple of times just to try and get it level with the rest of the mesh, and then simply take one of these small zip ties, run it through the door and through this side and zip it shut. The queen is now trapped inside that cage on a frame. Take that frame, put that frame into your queenless hive. You could probably get away with leaving it there a week, because the emerging brood is going to accept the queen as their own, which is what it will be. Their feeder, bees on the outside, can feed the queen if they want. And it just means that she's protected inside that little cage. And hopefully the longer that she's in the hive, safe, the more time you've got for your bees to accept her. She'll also be laying brood, of course. And I do just think that that's going to be a much safer way of introducing queens to queenless hives.